टुडे प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार विल गिव लेक्चर ऑन द डिफरेंशियल प्राइसिंग इन द हायर एजुकेशन इन इंडिया. ड्यू टू द बजट शॉर्टफॉल्स कॉलेज आर फेसिंग डायलेमा इन द डिफरेंट इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेज एंड द हायर एजुकेशन. हाउ टू मैनेज दिस सिचुएशन, दिस विल बी डिस्कस्ड इन दिस पेपर. हाउ द college management will manage this situation, this is discussed in this paper. Due to importance of the higher education in the today's society, the provision of the higher education should be as efficient as possible in order to assure as many people as possible receive an education. This is the importance of the higher education in the today's society, and the, how the provision of the higher education should be efficient as possible in order to ensure receive an education. However, due to budget shortfalls, colleges are facing a dilemma. Budget shortfalls in the colleges are facing a dilemma. Colleges must find a tuition level that enables them to provide a top education while still making it affordable. Every college who is facing the dilemma must find a what will be the tuition level and how to provide a top education and how to make it the affordable. One solution of this problem may be through the differential pricing of the tuition in the engineering colleges in India and the higher education. Differential pricing of the tuition. The biggest rationale behind these practices is a difference in the cost. The difference in the cost in the different courses and the different will provide a solution. It is unfair for a student in a low cost major to subsidize the cost of someone in a major that costs the university much more profit. To make sure lower income students are not priced out of a major, colleges are using a portion of the revenue from the differential tuition for the financial aid. However, there is no one differential tuition plan that will work for the everyone. Before a college chooses to implement a differential tuition plan is important where the admission is not happening in many of the branches of the engineering colleges and the many of the courses of the higher education. Hence, this differential plan will help the college management. It must consider the effect of the changes will have on revenue, enrollment, and the financial aid. Changes will have on the revenue, enrollment, and the financial aid. However, with the proper research, a differential tuition plan is something that could allow colleges to more efficiently provide an education to its students. Hence, the differential tuition plan will be implemented. Introduction. In 2007, the College Board issued a report entitled Education Page, the benefits of the higher education for the individual and the society. Content in this report were a multiple study that measured the effect of the higher education on individual as well as society. One survey conducted determined median earnings of the full-time year-round workers aged 25 and the older. These results were categorized by the education level and can be seen in the table 1 below. Based on this result, it is clear that on an average, as an individual obtain more education, their earning potential increases. This table shows the median earning of the full-time year-round workers age 25 and older, that their earning and the potential increases for the professional degree. Of the $1,000 doctoral degree, this one, master's degree, this one, bachelor's degree, this one, associate degree, this one, some college, no degree, this one, high school graduate, this one, not a high school graduate, this one. And this saw the median earning of a full-time year-round workers age 25 and older, that the getting a higher education, you can earn more. And multiple studies that measured the effect of higher education on the individual and the benefit of the higher education on individual and the society can be seen in this report. Benefit of the higher education can be seen in this report, and this table shows that the if the person get the higher education, his earning ability is the more. The benefits of the more education are not just seen in the someone's median salary. This report also reported that the individual with higher level of education have a greater chance of being offered an employer provided pension and have a greater chance of being covered by employer provided health insurance. Right. This is the benefits of the more education on the medians of the salary. The benefits of the more education are not just received by the individual who obtained the education. According to the same report, when an individual earns a higher income because of their education, the government, college, more tax revenue. This means more money for different government programs. People with the higher level of education are also less likely to smoke, more likely to volunteer and donate blood. The result of this stress the importance of the making higher education accessible and affordable to many individuals as possible, because not only does the individual benefit from more education, but society does as well. The current problem is that instead of becoming more affordable, higher education is becoming less affordable. In a separate report entitled Trends in the College Pricing, the College Board listed the average tuition fee and fee paid by the student in private four-year, public four-year, and the public two-year college for the previous 5 years. This list can be found in the table 2. This study clearly shows that the average tuition pricing are the rising. As a result, current students are being required to pay for more their education than the previous student. This is demonstrated in College Board entitled Trends in the Student Aid. Year 2003-04, private 4 year, this fee. Annual change, this one. 2004, annual change, this one. 2005-06, annual change, this one. 2006-07 annual change, this one. 2007 annual change, this one. Public 4 year annual change, this one. For the every year, public 2 year. This study shows the average tuition prices are rising. Tuition prices are rising. This is demonstrated in College Board report entitled Trends in the Student Aid. We saw how the effects of the grant have been decreasing. In 1986-7, the maximum Pell grant covered 52% of the average tuition fees, room, and the board at a four-year public university. However, by 2006-7, the maximum Pell grant covered only 32%. In 1991-92, all grants made by the 63% of the total aid, while loans consisted of the only 35%. However, by the 2006-07, grants made up by the 46% of the total aid, while loans were 49%. The issues of increasing tuition and decreasing aid created a problem for colleges when it comes to setting tuition level. If tuition is too high, potential student who are otherwise qualified may not be able to attend. However, a school with the too low of a tuition rate may not have the revenue stream necessary to provide their tuition with a top of the line education. This means that the school have to find the tuition level that allow them to provide a top education while still making it affordable for as many people as possible. The problem is that there may not be a single tuition rate that allows a school to accomplish this. One possible solution to this problem may be through the differential pricing of the tuition. This is the solution. If the tuition fee is high, potential students who are otherwise qualified may not be able to attend the course. However, a school with the too low of a tuition rate may not have the revenue stream necessary to provide their student with a top of the line education. Hence, both the cases have been discussed here. If the too level of the tuition fee, then the revenue stream necessary to provide their student with a top level of education. This means that the school have to find the tuition level that allow to provide a top education while still making it affordable for many people as possible. The problem is that there may not be a single tuition rate that allows a school to accomplish this. One possible solution to this problem may be through differential pricing of the tuition. This is the solution of the many of the colleges which are existing in India. Many of the engineering colleges in the India is existing the problem of the tuition fee and the admission. This is the possible solution through the differential pricing of the solution. Differential pricing of the tuition. Tuition rate vary from school to school across the country. Even within the same school, students within the same tuition rate will pay different amount for their education because of the financial aid. This is the situation. Tuition rates may vary from school to school across the country. Even within the same school, students with the same tuition rate will pay different amounts for their education because of the financial aid. In order to allow access to as many students as possible, varying amount of the financial aid is given out in the form of the scholarship, work study program, and the loans. Because if this, the amount someone actually has to pay for their education varies on a student by the student basis. Currently, most colleges already price discriminate when it comes to the tuition. They do this through the resident and non-resident tuition rates. Students are charged more simply because they are not a resident of the state that school is located in. However, universities are now starting to explore other ways of the varying the tuition. Some common practices that colleges are include charging different rates for the different majors, charging different rates for the different classes, offering quantity discount based on the credit load, giving discounts for taking classes during the unpopular time, such as evening and the summer, and charging tuition based on the students per student year of the college. This is the differential pricing of the college. Some common practice that college are including charging different rates for the different majors, for the different courses, charging different rates for different classes. For the different classes, they may charge offering quantity discount based on the credit load. Quantity discount may be provided on the credit load, giving discounts for taking classes during the unpopular time, such as evening or summer, and charging tuition based on the student's year of the college. This report will explore these differential tuition practices, including examples from the different schools. It will look at how common some of these practices are and the benefit of such a system. This report will show that a properly administered differential tuition strategy can increase the efficient provision of the higher education. Policy at the individual school. We will discuss the case study. Case study of the Kansas University. The following information comes from the Kaling article entitled Some Call Tuition Disparity Unfair. At Kansas University, tuition for in the state freshman is the $213 per credit hour. However, this cost can increase depending on what classes someone takes. This is because Kansas University has started charging additional fee for its classes. These additional fee range from $1380 per credit hour in the School of the Journalism to as a $146.8 credit per hour for master degree classes offered in the School of the Business. KU Provost Richard Levieux is not too happy about the practice. He states that I don't know any university president or the provost who are happy with the differential tuition. In some ways, it is an indictment of the political process we go through in the setting tuition. He states that he would like nothing better than to be able to get rid of the differential tuition across the board. It sends the message that some degrees are with more than others, which is not right. Levicare is worried that the large tuition increases for some degree may be pricing some student out of that major. For example, a lower income student may pursue a less expensive major like Spanish or English instead of the engineering degree. This is an example. A lower income student may pursue a less expensive major like Spanish or English instead of the engineering degree. However, Levier's worries might not hold true. KU spokesman Levier states that the university has started to do research on the minority enrollment. He has noted that early indicators show that there has been a slight increase in the number of the minority students in the certain program like engineering. This may be due to the fact that, according to the Levier, a significant portion of the tuition is set aside for the scholarship money. For example, in the School of the Law, Dean Gail Agrawal states that approximately 1/4 of the all differential tuition money goes to student scholarship. Dean William Forrest of the School of the Business explained the rationale behind the new pricing strategy. He states that the student came to him requesting differential tuition. They have getting paid less because they did not have a specialized degree like finance or the supply chain management, that their competitors at their school have an undergraduate business student pay an extra $86 per business credit hour. This extra money has allowed the School of Business to add 4 new majors, about 10 new faculty positions, and about $500 per year in the new scholarship and the salary. Forrest said this was a highly student-led process. Students, so this is an opportunity to invest in their career. We are just executing the plan the student developed. Meanwhile, School of Journalism Dean and Anna Verley said that we are only using differential tuition money for the things student can use. The school has invested the money in the computer software and the student salary. This is the case of the University of the Kansas, that the differential pricing is used for the different courses. Differential pricing is used for the differential courses. University of the Wisconsin Madison, starting in the fall of the 2007, student in the University of the Wisconsin Madison School of the Business began paying $500 from the each semester. Like the proposal at the Kansas University, the proposal for differential tuition at the Madison also generated student support because they believed it would support things like a top-notch facility. Student Jency Selgin, and it is important to all students in the business school to sustain our reputation. According to the proposal, state support does not provide the resources needed to maintain the quality of the undergraduate business program relative to the competing institution, particularly in recruiting and retaining top faculty. By charging a higher tuition for the undergraduate major, the School of the Business can maintain faculty quality, enhance academic and the career preparation, and offer business tuition to more student bennies. Like the KU, Madison was also worried that the lower income student might be priced out a major. And this is why 25% of the revenue from the differential tuition fee are the financial aid to the student enrolled in the program. However, not everyone is a fan of the increased rate University of the Wisconsin feel. This is not the preferred way to do this. If we were able to raise the resources uniformly across the campus, that would be a preferred move. But with our current situation, it does not seem to us that that is possible. Greater. This is the case study of the University of the Wisconsin Madison. Utah State University. The following information comes from Dermatest article entitled Tuition, Earn More, Pay More. Eric Diffes, a senior business major at the Utah State University in the long run, has seen his tuition slowly increase each year since he arrived. However, those increases were nothing compared to the increase he received last spring. That was when he received an email from the business school informing him that because he was a business major, his tuition would be an additional $4-5 per semester on top of the his $215 base tuition fee and the mandatory fee. For the first time, students at the Utah State John M. Houston School of Business who register for the upper division business classes are being charged on the additional $35 per credit hour. On average, this new fee will increase tuition by the $75 for the year. Despite some student concern about the additional financial burden, there are the supporters of the system. Schools defined the practice saying that it helps them maintain their program and compete with the private colleges for expensive professor and the programs. Business school deans maintain that the tuition hikes are necessary so that the business school at the public university don't fall behind their peer schools and the potential risk losing accreditation. It is moved that it is better for the students in the long run. According to the Douglas Anderson, Dean of the Utah State University Business School, where differential tuition fee will rise an additional $1 million for the school of this year. It goes to the question of the brand value of your degree. Do you recruit top talent or do you fail to keep pace with the new talent? It is out there. Students at the Utah State are already receiving the benefits of the new policy. With 7 new professors and the new program, such as a trip to Europe, this will fall where major business majors learn about the global marketing. At the Utah State University, this is the case of the Utah State University. How common are these policies? The Western Interstate Commission for the Higher Education is a public interest agency established to promote and facilitate resource sharing, collaboration, and corporate planning among Western states and their colleges and universities. Member states include Alaska, Idaho, Oregon, Arizona, Montana, South Dakota, California, Nevada, Utah, Colorado, New Mexico, Washington, Hawaii, North Dakota, and the Wyoming. As part of the November 2007 report entitled Tuition and Fees in the Public Higher Education in the West, they conducted a survey about the tuition policy among their member schools. Part of this survey involved two questions about the differential tuition practices. College were first asked if their institution charged its student at the different amount based on their year of the college or the number of the credits they have accumulated. Of the 1074 year public colleges in this area, only 6 schools, 4 of which are located in the Montana, imply this type of the differential tuition, which is 5.6% of the schools in this area. In the second question, colleges were asked if the institution charges its student a different amount based on the student program of the study. 27 out of the 107 four-year public colleges in this area imply this type of the differential situation, which is about 25% of the schools in the area. However, most of the schools in this area that practice this type of the differential tuition are located in just 3 states. California with 10 schools, Colorado with the 6 schools, Arizona with the 5 schools. The other 12 states have just 6 schools that use this type of the differential tuition. How can are these policy? We have seen that the different colleges are adopting that the differential pricing to charge the student. Who can price discriminate? In this article, is higher education becoming a commodity? Dhoti developed a statistical model for the period of the 1992 to the 2000 to determine what schools are better or less able to effectively price discriminate. He makes the blanket statement that the private colleges and university are the price discriminator. He explained this by stating that there is no question that if a college has the ability to price discriminate effectively, such discrimination will increase its bottom line revenue. However, according to the article, many experts in the economics of the higher education argue that the colleges and university are losing their ability to effectively price discriminate. Dorothy tests this hypothesis by comparing tuition, financial aid, and enrollment data from 1992 and 2002 for the 17 different colleges and universities. He divided these schools into the 3 groups based on their median scores on the scholastic aptitude test, which showed how selective a school is. However, he concluded that the ability for the colleges and university to effectively price discriminate in the decline. However, we found that the ability varies depending on the selectivity of the school. He concluded that more selective schools have a greater ability to price discriminate, while the less selective schools lack the ability. Reasons for the differential pricing. Why the differential pricing will be adopted? Here the reason is given. In this article entitled Differential Pricing of the Undergraduate Education, Yanisco and Wilson sought to explain the rationale behind why differential pricing is gaining popularity in the undergraduate education and what type of institution should use this practice. They also give their own plan for the differential tuition. A university with a flat tuition rate for the all students face a dilemma when it is faced with the declining revenue. This is the case in the Indian scenario of the engineering education. Flat tuition rate is facing the declining the revenue. If they decide to raise those rates for the everyone, then students in the low demand fields may change major, transfer to another school, or decide to leave the higher education altogether because the cost now outweighs the benefits. This is the situation when the flat rates are taking place. However, if a university try to keep tuition low, they run the risk of the not being able to maintain quality program in the major that can be expensive to operate. Both the cases have been discussed here. A flat rate is also unfair to the student. When a school has a uniform tuition fee rates, it forces the student in the low cost area to subsidize the education of the students in the higher cost area. Yanisky and Wilson state that students preparing to be school teacher should pay less for their undergraduate instruction than engineering student because the latter are both are expensive to instruct and more likely to earn a substantial income after graduation. There is already a long history of the differential pricing when it comes to the graduate program. graduate students are charged more than the undergraduate student in general, and the rates are vary depending on the cost and future earning. This model is now being expanded to include undergraduate. Schools are using different ideas about how to differentiate their tuition rate. These ideas include having tuition prices scaled in proportion to the cost of the program, higher prices for the upper division instruction because they are more specialized and costly to operate, higher prices as an indicator of an outstanding program, and setting prices according to the return on investment estimates for that field of the study. Based on their research, Yanesky and Wilson determined the because of the differences between the individual colleges and the numerous approaches to the differential pricing. There is no one method that is the best. However, they give a generalized plan for the university. Their three-part plan is as follows. Most, if not all, lower division instruction should carry a uniform tuition rate in order to prolong and choice process for entering student and to increase enrollment in the liberal study courses. Tuition charges for the selected upper division specialization should vary according to essential and the significant differences in the academic cost, but as a service institution. Colleges and university should neither seek to recover the full cost of the program nor rigidly apply cost formula when determining tuition prices. And third, at least during a transition period, approximately 1/5 of any increased revenue accrued by the differential pricing should be reserved to aid needy students whose selection of a certain fields of study otherwise might be restricted. This proportion should be modified by the institutional experience. They go on to state that the drawbacks to such a system may be very minimal. Research to date does not indicate that the significant number of the students will alter their enrollment preferences in response to modest price differential. Since upper division students tend to have a higher degree of institutional loyalty, they are not likely to alter established enrollment pattern simply because of the price differences. While their plan is for a wide range of the colleges and university, the authors warn that not every institution is suited to their plan. Some colleges will not have sufficient program diversity to implement this plan. The cost for the specific program can be difficult to assess because of the crossover between the department. Also, it not be beneficial for the top institution whose tuition rates are already high. So, which institution can implement differential pricing at the undergraduate level? The most eligible instructions seem to be large and well-respected, but not elite, with considerable diversity in their undergraduate curricula, including a mix of the technical and the professional program, and with a fairly strong recruitment position in their preferred market. The authors give advice to those looking to the implement differential pricing. Experimentation with the differential pricing can begin selectively and cautiously in proportion to the confidence that decision makers have in their general understanding of the relative cost differences. Student response by the major. In their article entitled response to the tuition increases by the academic majors, empirical grounds for the cost related tuition policy, authors Seam and Milton explore the effect that an increase in the tuition will have on different majors. According to Seam and Milton, this is important because more colleges and universities are facing budget shortfalls. This is the case of the many of the university and colleges that facing the budget shortfalls. One way to increase tuition revenue is to charge different tuition rate for the different academic majors, based on differences in the actual expenditure. It is important to know how students will respond to these different tuition fee. They state that the primary goal of the cost-related tuition is to increase tuition revenue without losing student. They had the same opinion of the Ionescu and Wilson that when tuition rate for the average student is unfair. From a purely economic point of the view, students in discipline that cost college less who pay the same amount on the other student are treated fairly unfairly by the student tuition policy. They collected data on the 470 public four-year colleges and the university. They wanted to see what effect tuition increases had on the six different categories of the major: education, engineering, physics, mathematics, biology, and the business. This result determined that the students have different tuition elasticity depending on their academic major. Tuition elasticity is defined as a change in the student enrollment causes by the change in the tuition. Engineering students seem to be unaffected by the tuition increases. The authors hypothesized that this may be due to the rate of the return of the major. Engineering students are expecting to earn more after college, so they are less sensitive to the tuition increases. They found that students in the other academic majors were more sensitive to the tuition increases. The author's suggestion is that the college apply diverse tuition rate for the academic majors by the considering rate of the return and cost of the discipline if the tuition increases is inevitable in a given situation. They feel this is a better solution than rising tuition for the student, every student. But using student tuition elasticity to the set different tuition rates of the different major, school might expect increased tuition revenue and without a loss of the student. And here is the case that the loss of the student should not be there. If you increase the tuition revenue, then the loss of the student will be there. Conclusion: setting an appropriate tuition rate for its student can be a difficult task for the colleges and the university. Unfortunately, there may not be one tuition rate that allows them to maintain an adequate revenue stream while still keeping the price affordable for as many students as possible. Differential tuition may be way to solve the problem. Differential tuition is the only way to solve this problem. Charging a flat rate for the everyone is unfair to the student in lower cost pay. This is unfair, a flat rate. However, if a school goes to the differential tuition policy based on the cost of the major, these students are no longer asked to subsidize the education of their peers in the higher cost field. Also, the students who are being asked to pay more will benefit from the top-notch facility and faculty that the college will now be able to provide, which will help them in their career after the college. The biggest potential drawback to this type of the system is a decrease in enrollment, especially students for the lower income families. However, this may not be a problem because schools are using some of the additional revenue from this policy for the financial aid. A school should not blindly implement a differential tuition policy just because a similar plan has worked in other schools. Due to differences in the makeup of the different colleges, this policy may not be effective at the every school. A school must take the proper time to do research on the potential effects a policy might have on revenue, enrollment, and financial aid. However, with the proper research, a differential tuition plan is something that could allow colleges to more efficiently provide an education to the student. This is the conclusion of our study, that the flat rate is unfair for the students at the lower cost field. Flat rate charge karna, this is unfair to the student. We have to adopt, हमें डिफरेंशियल ट्यूशन प्राइस एडॉप्ट करना चाहिए, वेयर द डालमा बजट डालमा इन द कॉलेज. द बिगेस्ट पोटेंशियल ड्रॉबैक ऑफ दिस सिस्टम इज टू डिक्रीज द इनरोलमेंट, स्पेशली स्टूडेंट फॉर द लोअर इनकम फैमिली. However, this may not be a problem because the schools are using some of the additional revenue from this policy for the financial aid. Setting an appropriate tuition rate for its student can be a difficult task for the colleges and the university. Unfortunately, there will not be one tuition rate and allows them to maintain an adequate revenue streamline while keeping the price affordable for many of students as possible. Differential tuition may be to solve the problem. Differential pricing problem is the only way to solve this problem. Differential pricing is the only way to solve this problem. We have discussed reasons for the differential pricing, why the differential pricing will be there. Who can price discriminate? How common are these policy? These have been a study of Utah State University, University of Wisconsin Medicine, and Kansas University policy at the individual school. Differential pricing of the tuition must be there. Here is given, this study clearly showed the average tuition prices are the rising. This showed the median earning of the full-time year-round workers age 25 and the older. This is the abstract differential pricing in the higher education, how the differential pricing in the higher education can be done.